Hello, I'm Roger. Thanks for tuning in. I have shown how to rear cuttlefish hatchlings in one of my earlier videos. If you are interested, don't hesitate to check it out by clicking the card on the end screen. These dwarf cuttlefish are almost 3 months old now and really showing signs of maturity. For example, catching them always results in the entire breeder box turning jet black with ink. Sometimes, they can really blend in with the surrounding environment, especially at night, so that other inhabitants, such as this goby, would mistake them for white rocks. Communications of richer forms are observed among individuals. Besides the remarkable ability to control the pigment in their skin, cuttlefish add to this unique visual communication certain swimming postures and gestures of their tentacles. And they are capable of showing an entrancing light display at their will. Their hunting behaviors have become very tactical as well, especially when they are trying to sneak on predatory inverts, such as blue crabs. If you have no idea of how to capture a crab that has large claws stretching out wide, you shall definitely watch this video, and a cuttlefish will teach you how. So, this is a blue crab I caught the other day, and it is savagely ferocious. Bravery is written in its genes and run in the blood. Can cuttlefish win the battle? Let's sit back and see. There we go. The cuttlefish immediately sneaked up on the crab at the side of it. Look closely how it approached the prey. The attack was planned on the rear of the crab by an overwhelming strike at lightning speed. The crab waved its sharp claws, trying to counter the predator, but to no avail. The cuttlefish entangled the crab firmly with its powerful arms. It is said that cuttlefish have a razor-sharp beak, similar to a parrot's beak, hidden behind the base of 8 arms, which enables cuttlefish to feed on hard-shelled animals such as crabs, and the bite introduces a toxin to quickly immobilize any troublesome prey. As we can see, the crab started to lose consciousness and stopped struggling as a result of exposure to such toxin. It looks like the cuttlefish enjoyed its meal pretty much. All the hard work had been well worth it. The body of the crab was cracked open and completely eaten, with only its shell left behind. This time, let's try a bigger crab. This is a yellow shore crab. Shore crabs are scavengers and are less fierce compared with blue crabs. But size matters. This one is several times as big. Were cuttlefish still able to subdue it? Let's wait and see. A cuttlefish discovered it and launched an attack as soon as the crab entered the breeder box. The first attempt was unsuccessful, but it did intimidate the crab. The cuttlefish learned from its prior mistakes and carried out a second attack from behind without a let up. Time to strike! Good job! The crab was able to struggle a bit before the toxin took effect, but very soon it lost control over its mind. The abdomen was no longer wrapped under the body. Its claw and the leg were also broken by the cuttlefish, falling off helplessly. To some extent, seeing cuttlefish eat is basically the same as watching a horror film. Cuttlefish are another example of how something's name doesn't even come close to describing the fear that these creatures inspire when they get a hold of their prey. Here are just another two clips about cuttlefish predation on shore crabs. Please enjoy. What if a crab has its abdomen protected? Will cuttlefish still stand a chance? Hermit crabs, with their fragile exoskeletons protected in mollusk shells, are what I would say an absolute genius in this regard. Look at how cocky the hermit crab is, marching towards the predator. Knowing that there was no chance of winning, the cuttlefish slowly backed away. To sum up, cuttlefish catch preys by striking at their weakest point, entangle and pull them towards the beak, and finally chomp and inject toxin to quickly paralyze them. For faster moving preys, such as shore shrimps, cuttlefish turn their bodies into entrancing light shows to hypnotize preys before they strike. What we could learn from cuttlefish predation are threefold. First, when battling with your opponents, do not fight head on. Second, approach them slowly, but strike fast. Finally, trick and distract them if needed. On the other hand, if we encounter a strong enemy like a cuttlefish, we should learn from hermit crabs to strengthen and protect us in our weaknesses. Before saying goodbye, I'll show you some interesting off-topic findings of cuttlefish, that is, how they excrete. Cuttlefish discharge wastes through siphon, which is an organ of the respiratory system as well. Cuttlefish ink, produced in the ink sac, is also released by a jet of water from the siphon. Speaking of pooping, perhaps the most imaginative of all, and the one that many would love to see, is how garden eels poop. I'll show you why in my future videos. And as always, if you ever have any questions or suggestions, please feel free to drop a comment below and I'll be happy to answer them. Subscribe to my YouTube channel to get the latest updates, and thanks for watching.